Hello friend, welcome to my channel Digitech. Today I am going to show you how to do heat load calculation by E20 form. जो आपकी स्क्रीन पे आप देख रहे हैं ये E20 form है. इसको पूरा कैसा फिल करना है मैं आपको बताऊंगा और आपको आपका हीट लोड कैलकुलेशन जो भी रूम का आप कैलकुलेट कर रहे हैं वो आपको मिल जाएगा. तो चलिए वीडियो स्टार्ट करते हैं. पहली स्टेप है आपको स्पेसशीट बनानी है. ये आपका जो भी रूम है वो आपको सिलेक्ट करना है, उसका ड्राइंग लेना है. तो जैसा कि आज मैं इस रूम के लिए हीट लोड कैलकुलेशन कर रहा हूँ तो आप देख सकते हैं ये वो रूम है. ये इसका रूम का जो है साइज है 25 फीट बाय 30 फीट एंड हाइट है 15 फीट एंड ऑल विंडोज का साइज है 6 फीट बाय 4 फीट. ये जो विंडो है ये एंड ये है आपका पार्टीशन एरिया. क्योंकि ये कंडीशन नहीं है, ये कंडीशन रूम है, एयर कंडीशन रूम है, ये भी कंडीशन रूम है, लेकिन ये आपका जो है वॉशरूम है ये कंडीशन नहीं है. तो यहाँ से यहाँ तक जो है आपका ये पार्टीशन एरिया हो जाता है. और इसकी हाइट जो है आपको वो फॉल सीलिंग तक लेनी है. मीन्स ये टोटल हाइट है आपकी सॉफिट ऑफ स्लैब तक, हमको सिर्फ फॉल सीलिंग तक लेनी है. जैसा कि मेरे इसमें ड्राइंग में इसकी हाइट में 12 फीट लिया हो और इसकी विड्थ जो है 12 फीट है. तो चलिए देखते हैं इसको कैसा फिल करना है. 25 × 30 यू विल गेट एरिया ऑफ दैट एरिया 750 एंड नेट वॉल एरिया लेना है आपको. मीन्स नेट वॉल एरिया मीन्स इसका विड्थ एंड हाइट. तो आपका इसका जो है नॉर्थ एक्सपोजर है, ये वेस्ट एक्सपोजर है, साउथ है एंड इधर साइड का ईस्ट है. तो हम पहले लेंगे वेस्ट लेंगे 25 फीट बाय हाइट 15 फीट. यू विल गेट समथिंग वैल्यू सब्सट्रैक्ट एरिया ऑफ विंडो मीन्स 6 × 4 यू विल गेट 351 एंड फॉर नॉर्थ 30 × 15 माइनस योर विंडो एरिया 4 × 6 यू विल गेट 426 एंड देन योर दिस कॉलम वेस्ट साइड विंडो एरिया 6 × 4 यू विल गेट 24 एंड फॉर नॉर्थ साइड 6 × 4 यू विल गेट 24. देर इज नो विंडो इन साउथ एंड ईस्ट and no wall exposure in south and east. Then roof area you will get 750 from area of the room. Then partition area means 12 from this point to this point, there is a 12 width and height up to fall ceiling is 12 feet. 12 × 12 you will get 144. Then I am going to show you how to fill this data: CFM per feet square, CFM per person, electrical load, lighting load, number of people. Electrical load आपको 1.5 ही रखना है, बाकी other data आपको ASHRAE ventilation जो system है आपको उसमें मिल जाएगा. यह है ASHRAE का ventilation का data, यह आपको ASHRAE standard 62.1 में मिल जाएगा. जिसमें हम इस रूम के लिए कैलकुलेट कर रहे हैं. आप जो भी आपकी जो रिक्वायरमेंट है उसके हिसाब से आप ये डाटा चूज कर सकते हैं. मैं क्लासरूम के लिए कर रहा हूँ. तो आप जैसा कि देख सकते हैं इसका CFM पर पर्सन 10 है. CFM पर पर्सन 10, CFM पर फीट स्क्वायर इज इक्वल टू 0.12, ऑक्यूपन डेंसिटी इज 25 फॉर 1000 फीट स्क्वायर. तो जैसा कि हमारा CFM पर फीट 0.12 है, CFM पर पर्सन 10 है एंड नंबर ऑफ पर्सन 25 है. तो 25 1000 के लिए है, 1000 के लिए है. तो हम जो है डेटा जो है 750 के लिए कैलकुलेट करेंगे. तो 750 × 25 divided by 1000, you know something wrong. 750 multiply by 25 something going wrong divided by 1000 yeah 18.75 I am getting means 19%. So I am taking here 19% and lighting load we will get from LPD data. This is LPD lighting power density. You will get this data from HRA 90.1. I am considering for classroom. Where is classroom? Classroom. I am considering 14.4 watt per meter square is value given here, but I want in watt per feet square. So I am dividing that value 14.5 by 10.76. I will get in watt per feet square. So हम यहाँ पर put करेंगे वो value. मुझे 1.22 मिला है. आपको जो मिलेगा आप वो put कर सकते हैं. Then go for project detail. ये आपका project detail है. ये आपको डिजाइन डाटा में मिलेगा. ये मैं इशरे में से लिया हूँ. मैं हैदराबाद के लिए कंसीडर कर रहा हूँ. तो लैटिट्यूड इज 17.86, एल्टीट्यूड इज 544, डेली रेंज इज 14, ड्राइवर टेम्परेचर इज 106 एंड वेट बल्ब टेम्परेचर इज 78. दिस एल्टीट्यूड इज गिवन इन मीटर्स, सो आई एम कन्वर्टिंग दैट इन feet. So I am getting the value and put here. So you will get this value from that table. Then next go for cooling load. Put your location, daily range, drive bulb outside temperature, wet bulb outside temperature, and this remaining value you will get from psychometry chart or any psychometry software. We have to maintain 76 degree Fahrenheit temperature in room and 50 degree relative humidity. Remaining three value we will get from psychometry chart. This is the temperature difference. 106 minus 76 you will get 30, 78 minus 63 you will get 15, 100 minus 67 you will get 33. This is a humidity ratio grain per pound. So for next, here use room length is 30 feet, width is 25 feet, you will get area 750, height is 15, and you will get volume by multiplying this all values. Means area multiplied by height you will get this value. After that, north side glass area we have got, north side glass area is 24 and west side is 24. So here north side glass 24, west side 24. Then we will go for heat gain. So there is a heat gain chart. You will find this chart in Ishre book. For 20 north latitude, as you know, for project detail we have latitude of 17.86 degree. For because of that I am considering 20 degree If you have value more than 20 or 25, you can go for 30 degree. You will get this table from Ishray. So for I am considering for July to May, because in India and Hyderabad, temperature of Hyderabad is high in July to May. So I am considering for July to May. We have two directions exposed. One is north and another one is north and west. So for north, from 8 p.m. to 4 p.m. take maximum value. For north, 8 p.m. to 4 p.m. you can see 23 is a maximum. And for south, from 8 p.m. to 4 p.m. 14 is a maximum value. No, it's west na. For west side, from 8 p.m. to 4 p.m. 163 is a maximum value. So put that value here, 23 163. And for SHGC, you will get this data in Ishray. So glass, I am considering light. आप जो भी चाहते हैं वो consider कर सकते हैं. तो मैं ऑर्डिनरी ग्लास कंसिडर कर रहा हूँ लाइट कलर का, जिसका वैल्यू है 0.56. तो जैसा कि आप देख सकते हैं SHGC 0.56 मैंने पुट किया हो, तो मुझे BTU पर और में वैल्यू मिल गया है आप मेरा. नेक्स्ट है सोलार एंड ट्रांस गेन वॉल एंड रूफ. तो हमारे टू साइड्स में वॉल एक्सपोज है, वन इज नॉर्थ साइड एंड वन अनदर वन इज वेस्ट साइड. तो 426 एरिया इन नॉर्थ साइड नेट वॉल एरिया, एंड इन वेस्ट साइड आई हैव 351 स्क्वायर फीट एरिया. फॉर टेम्परेचर डिफरेंस, दिस वैल्यू यू विल गेट टेम्परेचर डिफरेंस, यू विल गेट दिस टेबल इन Ishray. फॉर विच साइड वी हैव, one is north and another one is west. For north side, there is north. I am considering this is 8 inch, 100 means 8 inch, 60 means 6 inch. For I am going for 108 inch. For 100 lb square feet per square feet, maximum value from 8 a.m. to 4 p.m. is 4, and another one direction is for west direction, 8 p.m. to 4 p.m. maximum value is 12. And put this value, I have put the value west for 12 and not 2. For CF, I have another slide. For CF, we have 14 daily range degree Fahrenheit, and outdoor minus indoor temperature, outdoor minus indoor temperature, we have 30 degree temperature difference, and 40 degree daily range, 14 degree, 18, we got 18 from this table. Go for table, 18 degree CF. 18 degree CF, we got temperature difference 30 and 22. And for roof, from this data, where is roof, TD roof, for exposed sun 8 p.m. to 4 p.m. for 80 lb per square feet, we got 32. For I have put it this value 32 plus CF is constant to for wall and roof, I have put it 18. I got 50, 30, 22 and 50. Put this value, in table 30, 22, 50. For U factor, we have to go here. You will get this table in ASHRAE and ISHRAE both. For masonry, 8 inch concrete block, 0.49 value. For masonry, for partition masonry, we got 0.40. And for for wall, and for roof sun, we got roof ceiling 0.08. So put that value in our E20 form, we got 0.08, and by multiplying this value we will get 300 multiplying 426, 22 and 0.49, this value will come. After that, transgain except wall and roof, all glasses size in square feet, 24 plus 24 we will get 48, outside dry bulb temperature minus inside dry bulb temperature from here will get 30 degree, and factor we have to go where is factor, for here source is ISHRAE. I am considering half inch glass without storm window, without storm window 0.55, so put here 0.55, and we have floor area 750, and this value will get from this 0.34 ceiling floor concrete 4 inch 0.34, put that value here 0.34, then after temperature difference is outside temperature minus inside temperature minus 5, means outside temperature minus inside temperature is 30, minus 5 we will get 25. And we also have partition 144, so put here partition value, how much we have 144, and temperature difference is outside temperature minus inside temperature minus 5, we will get 25. And for factor we have to go for this table having partition for masonry is 0.44, so put that value in this table 0.44, not here 0.44. So I got 1584. After that, go here for ventilation. We have number of how much amount we have for number of people. We have 19 people, so put here 19 and CFM per person from spreadsheet we have 10 CFM per, and multiplying 9 into 10 190, then we have 750 square feet area and 0.12 CFM per square feet from spreadsheet, 0.12 and 10 put here, we will get this value, and 190 plus 90 280. After that we have crack length. How to find crack length? So we have two window of side of size 6 by 40, so perimeter of this we will get by measuring 6 6, then 6 plus 4 plus 4 we will get 6 6 20, and for this we will get perimeter 20, means 20 plus 20 40. So put here 40, then this is a factor, put 0.37, same as it is, same we got this value. CFM infiltration 14.8. after that go here infiltration, we got 14.8 value from here, and 39 from no CFM ventilation, we got 280 na ventilation, how much we got 3 280. So after that go for internal heat calculation. We have 3 people, 19 people, and this value you will get from ASHRAE table. You will get this table in ASHRAE. For 75 we have room temperature 76, so 75 is near. I am considering high school, seated very light work, sensible heat is 240 and latent is 160. So I have put it here sensible 240 and this number of people 19, we will get this value. After that light load, we have total area 750 and we also have LPD 1.22, so put this LPD 1.22, you will get this value.
She knows my friends.
By multiplying both, and this is a constant factor, you will get this value. After that you have 70 for appliance, electrical appliance 750, put 1.5 constant, you will get this value. After that put 10% safety factor, you will get this value. By combining this all value you will get sensible heat. After that for latent heat we have infiltration 14.8 from here, 14.8, and after that we also have 751.5 for latent heat. And outside air we got this value from 280, will get this value to 80. Put here. After that, this is a humidity ratio. Humidity ratio you will get from this that side. Put here, this is a bypass factor constant 0.68 constant. You will get this value. You have 19 people. No. Put 33, you will get this value. And latent heat I have shown you 160. We have get from this value from this table 160. So put their value here, put that value here and take 10% safety factor, combine this value and for the take 10% extra for this value, you will get 4538. And room total heat means sensible heat plus latent heat, you will get this value. After that, for outside air heat, you have 280 CFM like this, and what is wrong? Oh, okay, and 280, and you know that humidity ratio is 30, temperature difference is 30 and humidity ratio is 33. This is a constant value. You will get this value. We got tonnage 4.7 and 55845 BTU per hour. By dividing this value 12,000, you will get 4.7. After that, go here. By dividing sensible heat by total heat, you will get ESHF value. Go for ADB table, apparatus dew point temperature. You will get this table in ASHRAE table. For 76 degrees Fahrenheit, 50 degree relative humidity, we have how much ESHF? 0.89 means that is near to 93 and ADP is 55. So put ADP is 55 and supply air temperature is, first we put here value 55, put here 55. We have room temperature 76, ADP 55. By 76 minus 55, multiply by 0.88, you will get this value. After that, this is a sensible heat value. After sensible heat divided by 1.08 multiply by 18.48, you will get this value from here. You will get 18.94 dehumidified air CFM. Put this value here and this value here. You will get 60 value from 55 plus 4.7 ton is in between 3 to 10, ADP plus 8. We have ADP value. ADP value we have 55. 55 plus 8 is 63. So you will get total LCFM 2692 fresh LCFM. So this is our E20 form. I have completed this form. So if you want this form, you will get this form from ISRE table, ISRE handbook. You will get this on online PDF. So if you have any doubt in this video, so you can text me in comment box. And agar aapko ye video pasand aaye to like, subscribe aur share karna na bhule. Thank you.
Okay.